The National Broadband Plan is a European-wide ambition from the European Commission to ensure every citizen in Europe has access to high-speed broadband by 2020. That plan was published in 2011, and on foot of that, Ireland published its National Broadband Plan, where it said by 2020, every citizen in Ireland would have access to high-speed broadband. Over the last 5 or 6 years, the commercial sector has delivered the majority of that plan, whereby now nearly 1.8 million of the 2.3 million premises have access to high-speed broadband. Huge investment has gone in from the commercial sector. Unfortunately, the remaining premises in Ireland, nearly 540,000 premises, will not get high-speed broadband from the commercial sector. And that is where the state is now intervening. The state will make the required investment now under the National Broadband Plan intervention to ensure every premises has access to high-speed broadband. So the ambition and the objective is to ensure no premise in Ireland is left behind. It's a national infrastructure, and it's a national infrastructure for the decades to come. So like water, like gas, like any utility, it's a significant build which requires a significant investment. So the challenge is the extent of the network that's to be built. We currently estimate there's nearly 100,000 kilometres of road network that we need to cover, 540,000 premises. So Ireland is faced with an extreme challenge of a low density ribbon development across all of our rural areas. That makes building any network a challenge.
I work here in Mayo, but I do a lot of remote work for companies in the US. So I guess my work doesn't only just benefit from broadband, but it relies on it 100%. We've had a long struggle with broadband here. I've been here 15 years. We've struggled until pretty much this year, where we've gotten better connectivity. The current internet is coming in like on a four-hop wireless connection over the hills, so we're still not connected fully to the national infrastructure. You can see as technologies improve, the wireless and then fibre coming down the line, and even, you know, 5G in the future, faster connection would be amazing, and looking forward to being connected properly.
Well, this is a significant build and a significant rollout of critical infrastructure across the country, and will take some years to build. The government is going to ensure that broadband connection points are enabled in the first year to 2 years, over 280 in total that have been selected by the local authorities to ensure local people can get to those connection points where they need high-speed broadband and are waiting for the overall network to be completed.
Well, it's opening up a new world. There is so many economic and social advantages to the access of high-speed broadband, whether it's working from home, better quality of life, revitalisation of your local community or your local area, the possibilities that there is between e-health, e-education, e-government. The list goes on.
Getting broadband for the first time, you know, it was a game changer. It meant the speed at which you could transfer files, the speed at which you could get emails, send information, and the volume and size of information has completely changed. There's many, many stories of farmers and how they're using technology to improve the productivity on their farms. You know, we've had customers saying they get an alert, they get a message about something that was supposed to happen on the farm, and you know, they wouldn't have otherwise known. And by actually having the knowledge of what's actually happening, that saves them many thousands of euros. So there's a huge return on investment in terms of technology.
High-speed broadband brought new opportunities for our business. It allowed us to expand both in terms of dealing directly with people one-on-one and also online providing programs around the world. We now see ourselves as more than just a local business. I've always felt that being located in a town like Ballinrobe, that should not be a barrier to you doing business worldwide. And by having good high-speed broadband, we've been able to push ourselves more and more out there.
So before we had high-speed broadband, everything was much slower. You were waiting for that moment when the internet would actually time out. And we use it as a teaching tool now, so it's great to have high-speed broadband because you can very much incorporate it into your classes. The project that our transition year students took on with the Age Action Ireland group was where they invited a group from the wider community who wanted to learn IT skills, and then basically the girls taught them exactly what they needed to know. So it means that they're more open to the world from their own sitting rooms or kitchens.
Consumers can expect an extremely good service when the network is built. Consumers will, for example, in most cases have at least 100 megabit to their door, and businesses can expect at least a gigabit. And that is a transformational service compared to the services that are currently available. So the objective of this national broadband plan is that people across the country will have comparable services at comparable prices, which will be a significant development compared to what the reality is today.
The National Broadband Plan is a once-in-a-generation opportunity to bring prosperity and economic justice to rural Ireland, giving us a more regionally balanced, more productive and more inclusive society. The opportunities that you will have will no longer be dependent on where you come from. For far too long, regional and rural Ireland has been left behind. The National Broadband Plan would change this. Now we're determined, through the National Broadband Plan, to make these opportunities a reality for everyone, regardless of where you live.